Very good morning. In this video, I am going to give some information about that seed testing and different methods followed for assessing that various quality. Also, we are going to discuss people getting into this individual quality wise protocol and their uses for assessing that various seed quality. I wanted to give you some information about that main objective of that seed testing and brief history of that seed testing, both at international level and national level. As far as the seed testing is concerned, it is a one of the science that deals with assessing the planting value of the seeds. So assessing that planting value of the seed is very, very important. Without that assessment, we cannot sell our produce as a seed in the market, both in the international market as well as the national market. So mainly to assess the planting value or suitability of the seed for planting. And in addition to that, by the way of seed testing, we will come to know the problems and probable cause associated with the seeds and the seed quality. So through this, we can assess seed quality problems and their probable causes, and also we can assess whether that whatever that processing operation was carried out so far for that particular seed lot, that is sufficient to meet out that international as well as national standard. That and all we can assess by the way of doing some seed testing operations. Then to determine the quality standards, so the determination of the quality standard is very much needed, because in India we are having a seed act. As per the seed act, that labeling is compulsory, certification is voluntary. In the case of label, we have to write that germination percentage, moisture content and physical purity, all those data we have to furnish. So to write that data, the seed must be subjected to that germination test, moisture content and physical purity analysis. In that way, that seed testing is very, very important. So to establish quality standards for labeling specifications, then to establish quality and provide a basis for price and consumer discrimination. So based on that quality only, the farmers or the consumers, they will purchase that material. So for that purpose also, that seed testing is very, very important. So these are all the main objective of that seed testing. As far as the history of that seed testing is concerned, the first seed testing station was established in Trended, Saxony in Germany, 1869, under the able leadership of Frederick Nobe. Frederick Nobe is a well-known person in the field of seed testing. He is popularly called as the father of seed testing. He written a book on handbook of seed testing, actually in a German language, in the name of Handbuch der Samenkunde, in the year 1876. In line with this development, the second laboratory was opened in Copenhagen, Denmark, under the direction of Muller Coast. Regarding that India and seed testing laboratories concerned, we were established seed testing laboratory in India during the year 1961. Right now, we are having more number of state seed testing laboratory and two number of central seed testing laboratory. One is located at NSRDC Varanasi. That serves as a central seed testing laboratory for almost all the crop except GMO, whereas that laboratory located at Nagpur Cotton, that serves as a central seed testing laboratory for GMO crop. So this is in short about history of that seed testing laboratory establishment. So after establishment of that seed testing laboratory, to know the quality of the seeds, to know the quality like germination, physical purity, moisture content, and seed health, all those parameters, almost all the people, they are need of that protocol, seed quality testing protocol. So for that purpose, so many agency or associations, they develop their protocol. All those protocols were given to their friendly countries. By that way, the people here and there, they started to follow different protocol for assessing the same quality parameters. As outcome of that, uniformity they are not able to achieve. Under that situation only, that ISTA, that is International Seed Testing Association, that association was started during the year 1924. The headquarters located at Zurich, Switzerland. So they are also working for development of the acid quality testing protocol. So their main motto is to achieve uniformity in acid quality testing across the globe. So under that intention, they are having different committees, and each and every committee, they are actively involved in the development of protocols for assessing the acid quality parameters. And whatever that protocol they develop, that is given to other country for adoptions. So that is one of the main agency responsible for development of the sea testing protocols. Apart from that AOSA, that is Association of Official Sea Analysts, that also established in the year 1908, they're also working for development of the protocols for assessing that sea quality through sea testing operations. So as we know that in India we are having that SEED Act. As per section number 6 of the Indian SEED Act 1966, that government of India, they fixed minimum limit for germination, physical purity, all those things. So once that particular SEED lot that fulfill that minimum limits fixed by the section number 6 of the Indian SEED Act, that alone become as seeds, or otherwise that material and all we cannot sell in, as a seed in the market. So section number 6 we have to fulfill. In addition to that, the section number 7 that deal about regulation of sale of the seeds, the notified variety, by compulsory labeling. So labeling is compulsory. So here I have given that label as well as that tag and all I have given here. Here you can see this a label. So this is a compulsory one. Without labeling, we cannot go for that sale. Whereas this and all tag for actually this is a tag given for that breeder seed. If it is a foundation, that will be given with white color. If it is a certified seed, that will be given with a blue color. So as per that section number 7 of that Indian SEED Act 1966, that labeling is compulsory and certification is voluntary. Suppose you are going for labeling, means you have to furnish all the datas. The datas, that data like the germination minimum, physical purity, then inert matter, genetic purity, moisture content, everything we have to fill up. Then only you can put up a label. So without filling all these informations, if you go for that sale, again that also you will be in trouble. That seed inspector will catch hold of you. Your license will be cancelled. So for preparation of the label and to know that quality as per that section number 6 of the Indian SEED Act, so seed testing is compulsory, it's a mandatory. Though regarding that seed testings, we cannot conduct quality assessment for the entire seed material produced from that particular field, because almost all the tests were that destructive one. So we cannot reuse those seeds or seedlings for our planting purpose. So almost all our seed testing operation is a destructive one, except that physical purity analysis. So because of that, here that quality of the seed lot is tested only based on the samples, only based on the samples received from the seed lot. So here that sampling is need to be done in a very strict manner. So because that sample alone going to represent the sample, whatever that quality is assessed for that sample, that alone going to represent the quality of that entire seed lot. So under that intention only, that ISTA, they developed a PAKKA protocol with reference to seed sampling. So that seed sampling methodology is given here. So here we have to take a different level of sampling, like a primary sample, composite sample, then submitted sample and working sample. So here say example that seed is kept like this, or seed is packed like this. So from this we have to take the prescribed number of the primary sample, Say example, if it is that huge quantity is kept like this, we have to take more number of primary sample from various depth, various locations. Here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, like that we have to draw primary sample. So after taking primary sample, all the primary samples are mixed together, that will form a composite sample. Then once that the composite sample is arrived, we have to go for that mixing and dividing in order to get that prescribed quantity of that submitted sample. So that seed testing protocols, we have a prescribed quantity for submitted sample as well as per working sample. Say example, if it is a paddy, we need to submit 400 gram of submitted sample to the seed testing laboratory. In seed testing laboratory, they will go for that mixing and dividing. By that way, they will convert that 400 gram into 40 gram. Like that, for each and every crops, we have a quantity specification with reference to submitted sample and working sample. So because of that, initially we have to take more number of primary sample. After that, all the samples are mixed together, that form a composite sample. After that, in order to arrive at prescribed quantity of the submitted sample, we have to follow that mixing and dividing operations. For mixing and dividing operations, we have some method and some instruments also available, or some manual methods are also available. I can give you those data in the upcoming slides. So by that way, you have to reduce the quantity of the composite sample and arrive at the prescribed quantity of the submitted sample. That sample will be packed and that will be submitted to seed testing laboratory for seed quality assessment. Immediately after receipt of that submitted sample from the producers or from the seed certification officials or from the seed inspector, seed analysis, actually he or she is a AO. In the name of that seed analysis, he or she is empowered to test verify the quality parameters of the seed sample at the seed testing laboratory level. So immediately after receipt of this particular submitted sample, they will go for that further mixing and dividing in order to arrive that prescribed quantity of the working sample. For that working sample alone, they will do that all the seed quality analysis. Normally the working sample sizes that should have 2500 number of seeds or prescribed quantity of the seed must be there. So that is a thing. So normally in the seed testing laboratory, they will receive three kind of samples, like a service sample, certified sample, official sample. Actually, service sample is submitted by the farmers. Directly they will submit the sample to the seed testing laboratory, mainly to know the quality standards of their produce, So by the way of knowing that the quality standards of their produce, they can go for preparation of that producer label, that is a TFL label. With that, they can go for selling of their produce as a TFL, that is a truthfully labeled seed, that is a service sample. Another one is a certified sample. So this particular sample is taken and submitted by the seed certification officers for the purpose of giving a certified seed tag or a foundation seed tag. So this is a certified sample. Another one is official sample. This particular sample is taken by the seed inspector mainly to know the quality of the seed sold in the market. So this sample directly taken by the seed inspector, that will be submitted to seed testing laboratory to know the quality of the seed sold in the market. Actually, for service sample, the farmer, whoever they are sending their material sample to the seed testing laboratory, they have to make a payment. Certificate sample, so normally that SEO, they will collect the seed testing charges at the time of that seed field registration itself, whereas official sample, the sample that charges will be paid by the seed inspector, not by the seed sellers. So these are the three kind of samples normally received by the seed testing laboratory for various purpose. Then regarding that principles of sampling, sampling is obtained from seed lot by taking small portion at random different places, that is a primary sample. After that, all those samples will be combined, that will form a composite sample. Then after that, we will go for that mixing and dividing operation in order to get that prescribed quantity of the submitted sample and working samples. Then once that submitted sample is arrived, that should be packed as per that Indian Seed Act 1966. In that we have to put up a label. That label should carry name of the crop, variety, class of the seed lot, and the quantity of seed in lot. So all those datas we have to, and also we have to specify that test record, whether that purity, germination, moisture content. In addition to that, sender's name and address also we have to give. And then I already told you, with reference to arriving that prescribed quantity of that submitted sample or working sample, we have to do that mixing and dividing. For mixing and dividing purpose, we are having that devices are available. Apart from that, for taking that primary sample itself, we need to follow a certain strategy. Either that hand sampling is followed, or dryers are available. Here you can see. So these are all the dryers are available. In Tamil, normally we call it as a kuttusi, and dryers are available. So either you can do that hand sampling or dryers, mainly for the purpose of taking primary sample from the seed lot. Normally, hand sampling is recommended for non-free-flowing seeds, or chappy seeds or fussy seeds, particularly cotton, tomato and carrot, tomato seeds and also somewhat hairy, cotton seeds also with the fuss, somewhat hairy nature, it's a non-free-flowing. In those cases, better we can follow that hand sampling operation, whereas that dryers or mechanical sampling is normally recommended for the free-flowing seed material. So we are having a different type of dryers, like tip dryers, no-fit dryers, stick dryers, sleeve dryers, like that. Different type of dryers are available. And weight of that working sample for moisture estimations. In addition to regular seed quality assessment, we have to take one more sample, that is for moisture estimation. And the material that need to be subjected to grinding for the purpose of seed moisture estimation, those cases we have to take 100 grams. Whereas some of the cases no need to give any grinding for moisture estimation, those cases we have to take 50 gram. So whatever that sample taken, either 50 gram or 100 gram, that should be packed in the moisture vapor proof container. Whereas that another submitted sample, that handle packed in the cloth pack, so we can send the sample. But the sample taken for moisture estimation, that should be packed in the moisture vapor proof container. So that is very, very important. So here that the size of that working sample and the size of that submitted sample is given here, size of the seed lot also given here. For paddy, the maximum seed lot size is 20,000 for paddy and equivalent size. And crop like maize, that the maximum seed lot size is 40,000 kg. And the small cedar crops like tomato, sesame, pearl millet, and those cases that the seed lot size is 10,000 kg. So per one lot, we have to submit one submitted sample. From that, they will arrive one working sample. That sample alone will be subject to that seed quality testing operations. Here you can see for paddy, the working sample size, submitted sample size is 400 grams, and working sample size is 40 gram. And wheat, maize, and red gram, and black gram, green gram, Bengal gram, cowpea, soybean, and groundnut, and these are the cases, 1000 gram, that's a submitted sample. So accordingly, that working sample size also given here. For other crops like chinchili, it's a small cedar crop, the maximum seed lot size is 10,000, and submitted sample size is 70, and working sample size is 7. For tomato hybrid, that seed lot size is 10,000 kg, and submitted sample size is 7, and working sample size also 7. So as per this, we have to take the sample. That sample should be submitted to that seed testing laboratory for seed testing purpose, seed quality analysis purpose. And then after receipt of that sample at a seed testing laboratory, they will go for that mixing and dividing in order to get desirable quantity of the working sample for seed testing purpose. So here they are following two methods, mechanical method and manual method. And in mechanical method, we are having the Tuponer divider, soil divider, and Gamet divider. So in the Tuponer divider, through centrifugal force of action, that seed will be divided into two halves. That is soil divider also, that seed will be poured in the top. That will have a 10 number of channels, 5 number of channels directed on this way, another 5 will be on another this way. So by that way, the seeds will be gets divided into two halves. The Gamet divider in the from the bottom, actually this is a Gamet divider. So the seed will be flow from the top. Here one platform will be there, the seed get bounce, either that will take this route, this outlet, or that outlet. So by that way, the seed will be divided into two halves. So these are all some mechanical devices available for mixing and dividing. Apart from that, manual method like random cup method, modified carving method, spoon method, hand carving methods are available. So by following all these methods, we can divide the seed into two halves. By that way, we can arrive at the prescribed quantity of the working sample. So these are all the matter with reference to that sampling process is concerned. So in the next video, I can explain the matter related to that physical purity analysis.